Hey guys, how's it going? So today I'm going to take you through the process of how I record and edit my videos. So I guess the quickest thing to get out of the way is the recording part. I just use my phone. So essentially, once I record usually a pretty lengthy session of an hour or longer, just depends really, but I just record in one take. Oftentimes I play my drums along to the Rock Band track. Occasionally I'll play them just to silence and only the visuals of the Rock Band track. Whatever it happens to be, I'll just record one big long video. So essentially the first thing that I would do is copy that file onto my desktop, which is right here. So as you can see, this particular file is an hour and 7 minutes long. So we're not going to worry about splitting the entire thing right now, but I'll kind of give a brief overview of how I go about this process. So essentially, we take that. So the program that I use is called the VideoPad Video Editor. The brand name is NCH, so NCH VideoPad Video Editor. It's treated me pretty well, so this is kind of what the interface looks like. As you can see, it's very, straightforward. Not a lot to it, you know, it's very limited in that regard, but at the same time, it makes it so that it's not complicated, which is what I like. So essentially, here's our interface. So I'm just gonna go to add a file, and I'm gonna find, there's that video file I mentioned, and it'll load. I just bring it right onto this track here. And there we can see the video at the top and the audio at the bottom. And essentially, here's the video preview right here. Here's what it looks like. So, some tuning, and then I try without the track. So this is just the isolated drums. So if I decide to go with that, I could just cut out that portion. Or I have the full track right here, so this is what it would sound like. So as you can see, I've purposely faded the background music down so that the drums are significantly louder. For a while, I was trying to have the background music quite a bit louder so that it would balance out a little bit better. But ever since I've been using the actual drumless tracks to do in post-editing, it just makes a lot more sense to mute it or, you know, dim it down at least in this recording, so that I can still hear it when I'm playing along to it. As you can see, I'm not wearing any earphones or anything. I'm just listening to it coming out of the speaker. So I have it pretty loud so I can hear it beyond my drums, but also to the point where it's not so loud that bleeds through too much. So essentially what I'm gonna do here is I'll just get to the point in the track. So probably right around there. I'll just zoom in a little bit. So that's a good place to cut it. So I'll just split that track and I'll get rid of everything at the beginning, close the gap in the track. So now it's right at the beginning of the recording here, as you can see. So this is where the song ends, right here. Right there is where it fades. So essentially I'm going to do another cut there and remove this. So now I've got just the track. So what I will do here is I'll export it. And then the preset is auto match 920 by 1080. So I'll leave that. Change the frame rate to 60 frames per second. And then I'm just going to go to my desktop. And I'm going to save it as day after day. There we go. So save that and create. So this literally takes seconds, as you can see. There we go. It's saved. So I'm going to get rid of this and get rid of that. And now I'm going to add day after day. And there we go. So here's the track. It's ready to go. So that's the video part of it. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through and use Audacity. So what I do in Audacity, and I guess I had it open already previously, so here we go. What I do in Audacity is if I have the Rock Band track, then of course it's easier to use that. If I don't, well then I'll just use an MP3. So here's Bad Finger day after day. So let's see if it works. Okay, so it will not work. So essentially now what I would do, because I want to make sure that I'm using the exact same version, is I'll close this and get rid of that. So what I'll use is I have this program that I can use for my Rock Band customs. So it's essentially C3 ContOOLS. Okay, so let's open this up. Hopefully it'll let us without the updates. Okay, so now I'm going to go to Visualizer, and then essentially I'm going to load the custom file. So I have it saved here. So it is Bad Finger day after day. So now, that recorded. So I've added the track here to the sequence. So essentially now that we have the actual track recorded, the next thing we have to do is get the drums removed. So this will be another one where I cut out my talking just so that I can get the full audio experience. But essentially what I'll do here is I will open RX8 Audio Editor. Sorry, before I do that, here is the track I just recorded. So I will save an audio clip as a new file. So it's just called Untitled 29 right now. So I don't need it. I just needed it to save. So it'll save to my music folder. So now if I go here in RX8 and open file and I go to my music folder, there's Untitled 29. So there'll be an echo here because this is recording through my phone, but just to demonstrate, if I play it, you'll hear that this is the track I just recorded. Okay, so there's the track. So all I'm gonna do here, because that's the full track, is then I'll scroll down and I'm gonna go to Music Rebalance. So I click on that and I do this with everything, so it's already preset, but normally everything is at zero, so gain for vocals, bass, percussion, and other. Everything else, obviously, I want to keep at the normal volume, but percussion I want to remove altogether. So I've got that right to the bottom. I have my quality set to best. This is the default separation. I've never really played with it, so I don't know necessarily how much better or worse it would be if I adjust it, but I just leave it where it's at. So then I normally hit preview. So what I'll do before that, since we know that the drums come in right around here, so again, there'll be an echo, but excuse that. The drums kick in right around here. So excuse the echo, but just hear the drums for a sec. Okay, so we know that's where the drums kick in. So I'll go a little bit before that and hit preview. Let's wait for that to process a little bit. Have been pretty much completely removed. So once I hear something that I'm satisfied with, I'll then just hit this render button. So it'll usually take a couple minutes because I am doing it in the best possible quality. So there you can see this is about a 3.5 minute song, but it's only going to take maybe a minute and a half or a little bit over for that to process. So basically we just wait for that to process. I don't like to do a lot in the background just because this is obviously going to be pretty tough on the processor and I don't want to slow it down any more than I have to. So we'll give this a second. But yeah, essentially once we have this file loaded, I'm just going to do a quick convert because it's when I saved it from video pad, separating it from the video file, it saved as a WAV file, which is fine at the end of the day. I could easily just use the WAV file, but I find that MP3s are a lot more universally accepted in most of these programs. So usually once this finishes converting, I convert the file type from WAV over to MP3 before we go back into video pad. So, of course, you know, the more processing that needs to be done, you know, I want to say that it's based on the difficulty of removal or the quality of the track or what have you. It can take longer than this. It also can be a lot shorter, but I would say this is about the average where it takes maybe a minute and a half or so for this to process, which isn't too bad considering you saw all I did was preview, you know, less than 20 seconds of the song. So not only is this rendering it for the first time, but it's also converting the entire thing all in one fell swoop and in less time than it actually would take to listen to the full song. So pretty impressive, honestly. Okay, so that's done. So then I just close this little window here and then I go to export and I switch it to MP3. I leave it at 256 kilobytes per second and okay, and I want to save this to my desktop and once again I'm going to call it day after day but not MP4, so just get rid of that. There we go. So we're going to save that as day after day MP3. So we now have the MP3, I can get rid of this and close RX8, we're done with that. So essentially, now we are back here. So actually I'm going to get rid of this because this is the video I'm currently recording. So obviously I don't need that. So what I'll do now is I will add the day after day MP3. So we've got that added. So now essentially, I'm gonna add another audio track here, and I like dragging it down to this one because the third one is a lot narrower for some reason. There we go. So we've got the audio track as well as my drum track. So essentially, the easiest thing for me to do is to just cut out the quiet section at the beginning so that, you know, there isn't a big bulk of quietness. So delete that, and we know that this is basically where it starts. So we know that this is the first drum hit because that's where the audio kicks in, and then this will be the first hit on the guitar. So just do a general lining of that. You can see the second one lines up pretty good, third one lines up pretty good, fourth one lines up pretty good. So overall, we're looking good there. This is where it lines up again. So basically, we just eye it up to start with to kind of see those key points and making sure that they line up pretty well. So essentially, that's when I would look at the end of it. You can see the fade pretty much goes to around the same area, so that's a good sign as well. So what we're going to do now is I'm going to cut out my microphone again so that I can record myself kind of troubleshooting the audio part. And then once we have something that sounds good, I will come back.
My mind is all around you.
So now that we've got that all aligned, I'm happy with that. So essentially, we've got, you might have noticed I was doing some adjustments as well. So without going through and playing it again, all I did on the drum, so this is the original video with drum, and then this is the MP3 with the drum removed. So all I did here is right click, and I went to effects, and I went to volume, and I just brought the volume down to 80, which is kind of where I start with, just depending on how much echo the drum recording has versus how loud the MP3 is, because that'll vary as well. So just trying to find a happy medium there. So I brought that down to 80 and that seemed to work. And then I also noticed that the MP3 was quite loud, which is good. Obviously the clarity is a good thing. But it was loud to the point where I think even with the drums at a good volume, the actual track itself was too loud. So I did the same thing there, went to effects, went to volume, and I changed that one to 90. So I want it to be louder, but not quite at 100. So that's what I did there. So basically that got us to where we are now. So essentially all I'm going to do there is, once again, I've got my video track and my audio track on there, so I'm going to export it, and 60 frames per second, going to make sure it auto-matches the content, so 920 by 1080, and then once again, we're going to go to the desktop, but this time you can see I've got my other video saved, so just for order's sake, this one will be 122, so basically, we're just going to call it 122 day after day, and we'll save, so create that. So this one will take a little bit longer, or not. See, nice and quick. Okay, so I'm gonna clear that. So essentially we've got nothing here that we need necessarily on the track anymore now that it's saved. So essentially we're just gonna go and get rid of this track, and then I'm also going to get rid of the original, and I'm also going to get rid of the MP3. So now what I'll do is, I've already got the template that I use for my daily videos, so essentially I'm going to open that. So it's this one. There we go. So this is the template that I have for my daily videos. But before I'm going to do anything here, what I'm going to make sure that I have is something for my thumbnail. So I like to keep it pretty simple. All I did, I searched Badfinger day after day. So name of the song, name of the band. If it's a well-known, very recognizable band, you know, I might go for a picture like this one, for example, that'll be a little bit bigger of a frame rate. It'll fill the screen. But Badfinger, while they're very recognizable, are probably not overly recognizable by looking at them. So I wouldn't necessarily use a picture like that in this case. So I would probably just stick with an album cover or something like that. So this one looks good. So I'll basically save image. And I'll save it here with all my other ones. So Bad Finger Day After Day, there we go. So I've got my picture, so that's perfect. So now we're gonna go back to VideoPad, and essentially all I wanna do here, I'll just zoom in a little bit. I've already got my template here, so I will go and I will go to my desktop where I've saved day after day. There we go, the 122 day after day. So we'll bring that here and throw that there.
and make sure that the end part also lines up properly. There we go, so that's good. And now I have this little cutout here, so essentially all I need to add there is the screenshot. So I forget, what was it called? Bad Finger Day After Day, I thought. Where did it go? There it is. Okay, so basically all I do is I line that up right there and drag that to line up to the bottom track, and there we go, that's added there. And then I will do the same thing at the beginning, so I'll add the screenshot a second time right in this little slot. There we go. And then essentially in the top part, this is where I enter in the band name. So my template was a Dream Theater song, as you can see. So let's change that to Bad Finger. There we go. And the name of the song, Day After Day. Okay, so we've got that saved as it should be. Now, one thing that we also want to do is to do a transition from the intro. So I click on transition, and what I like to do for the opening part is I do page curl. I hit OK, and then move for the overlap. So that's good. And then at the end, I do a transition again. This time I do doors and doors closing, and then I hit OK. And yes, move. There we go. So that part's good. Everything else here is good. We're not going to play a lot of this, basically just enough to see the intro and the transition. So I'm not going to worry about cutting out the audio, so excuse the echo. So this is basically what it'll look like. Transition at the beginning, and then I'll play a little chunk at the end here to see that closing transition. And there we go. So the only thing that I'm going to do here is I noticed at the beginning that the little bit here, The Patreon bit, was cut off, so I'm just gonna down the format size there a little bit, and that looks much better. And there we go. So this is my completed video. So now that that's finished, I will hit export again, and this time it'll be the same auto match, 60 frames per second. And I've already got it saved as 122 Day After Day, but you'll notice all of my finished videos are capitalized and spread out and all that, which is why I format it like this, because I can just select it, and then rather than saving it the exact same way, basically just clean up the title. There we go. So now 122 Day After Day, save, create. And this will take, you know, a couple minutes. This one will be a little bit longer than the previous ones, just because there's a few different segments that are merged together. So it's basically rendering the whole video. But essentially this one will take approximately as long as it took to remove the drum track using RX8. As you can see, it's moving along pretty quickly. So we basically just wait for that. And then once this is done, that's our video. So, super easy process, as you can see. I do it pretty much the same way every time. So, having the template makes it a lot smoother and makes everything just go pretty seamlessly. So, I mean, obviously the most time-consuming part is playing the song, but once the song is played, that's why I can record, you know, 10, 15, 20 songs in one take if I wanted to, because I could just come back to my computer, split the original tracks into individual tracks, and, you know, basically go through this process for each individual song. So there we go, I'll clear that, and I just like to undo until we get back to just the main template. There we go, so we're good there, and we are done with that. So now essentially, if I go back to my desktop, here is the saved video. So that about covers it. So basically that's a quick walkthrough of how I go about doing this. You know, pretty basic process. I definitely use a couple of different programs, none of which are super complicated to use. I guess the one that I didn't really talk a lot about was Audacity, just because the multi-track wasn't really usable for this song. So I'll just do a really quick demonstration of what makes it a lot easier, to be completely honest, because if I have the multi-track and I can use Audacity, I don't have to use VideoPad to record my screen. I don't have to use the Rock Band C3 tool to record the song. I don't have to use RX8 to remove the drums. I can literally use a master track and then just go straight to the editing. So essentially, if I have the master track, so I'll just show a quick one where I do. I just import audio, and I'm going to go to Rock Band because this is where the master tracks are. So let's say, for example, I wanted to play... Here, let's look at Deep Purple. So let's say I want to play Highway Star by Deep Purple, classic song. So essentially, I'm going to add all of these individual AUG files. So these are each of the individual instruments because these are master tracks. So essentially, I've now got them all split. So again, excuse the echo for a sec, but here's the original track with all of the instruments intact. Okay, so that's pretty normal. So essentially, I can completely remove the drums. I'm not going to remove them just yet. I'll just mute them. So I'll hit mute on drum track 1, mute on drum track 2, mute on drum track 3. Okay? So everything else is still on. So if I hit play again. You'll notice there's no drums anymore. So the other side of that is I can just have drums only. So if I decide, or you know, any other instrument, but let's say I just want to do drums. So I'll hit solo on drums and then unmute the other two because it's just easier to do it that way. So now I've got only drums. So let's play that again. So now this is the easiest way to go about doing this whole thing because I can completely remove the drum track, as you saw. So now let's just get rid of the drum tracks, no drums whatsoever, and then simple as export MP3 and it'll export. It'll export the track and there's no drums. And so I've already got my MP3 that I could put right into VideoPad to go along with my drum track, and I've skipped like 3 different steps. So provided I have the master track, this is the much easier way. But the way that I went through it with Day After Day, I don't have the master track for. So that's kind of the full process, which is what I wanted to share. So
Yeah, so this is basically it. So if you guys have any other questions, or you know, you want me to elaborate more on any part of this, definitely feel free to ask, feel free to reach out. I hope it maybe was helpful, or at least provided some insights, some ideas, some possible experiments, whatever you might want to look at it as. But other than that, yeah, that's about it. Thanks, guys. Talk to you later.